Hello, I'm Allison. Thank you so much for joining me for today's restorative yoga session. So, you're gonna need some objects. And don't worry if you don't have the exact same things as me when I first started my yin slash restorative practice. I used large cushions off of my couch. I used pillows, I used blankets. I just used common objects that I had around my house. So feel free to pause for a moment and grab some of those items if you don't have yoga bolsters or yoga blocks. We are going to get started with a cat-cow. You won't need anything for this. This is truly what you know it as. But I do want you to move a little freely with this movement today. Don't think about it in the restrictive way of yoga, but instead I want you to move into space that feels comfortable for you and feels, for lack of better words, like yummy, feels good to move into those positions. So we're gonna start on our hands and knees. And we're gonna take a big breath in. Now, traditionally, they would tell you to take a big breath in as you're rounding up, right? And let it out as you're releasing. I want you to do what feels right and comfortable for you today. So whichever way of breathing feels best, that's how I want you to move. We're gonna be here for a couple minutes. So just move with your breath in whatever way feels good to you. You might shift from one side to the other. You might have a more traditional cat-cow. Really doesn't matter as long as it feels good to your body and that you're not forcing anything. I personally can feel a little more tension and that I'm tighter on the left side. So I'm kind of moving into space that feels like it's giving me a little bit more room to move on that left side. You might make it a little more circular in terms of the way you move your hips. Be here for about three more long deep breaths. Articulation through your spine that feels good to you. Get there. And when you're ready, we're gonna go into a supported child's pose. So you may use one bolster, you may use multiple bolsters, you may add a yoga block in there. It's 100% dependent on what feels best for you. But what I'd like for you to do is spread your knees pretty wide. You're gonna sit your hips back and then you're going to drop down on your bolster or maybe your bolster in a block. Really just depends on, or maybe it's just a block, what makes the most sense for you. For me, I like to go down on one bolster. If you are turning your head to the side like I will be, you're gonna be here and I will tell you when to switch to the other side. That we can actually melt into some of these positions, shouldn't feel like we're actively engaging to do that. Mm-hmm. ahead and switch it to the other now. The top and release it slower than you inhaled. When you're ready, begin to come up off of your bolster or blocks, pillows, whatever you might be using. We do have one standing pose. I know that's not what you usually think of when you think of restorative, but we do have a forward straddle today, and we'll be doing both a standing version and a seated version today. So we're going to spread our legs nice and wide. We're going to have one yoga block. We're going to shift our hips back so that our head rests nice on our block. I usually like my forehead there. And we're just going to allow the arms to hang for a nice gentle stretch in the hamstrings. And if you need, if getting down to one yoga block doesn't make sense and you need to raise it up, that is totally fine. You can adjust your heights. You decide what makes the most sense for you. But I do want your head and neck to feel supported. Don't love being inverted like this, don't worry, we won't stay here as long as we do other poses. But I do want gravity to help open up the hamstrings, to help open up the low back. And you may find that the longer we're here, you want to adjust your block to a different height. Truly allow the upper body to just collapse towards the floor. There's no strain in your neck, your shoulders, your arms. Your arms are not holding you up at all. Begin to deepen your breath. And on your exhale, begin to roll on up. Hopefully that felt like a nice hamstring stretch and a release of the low back for you. All right, we are going to do a supported bridge. There are a couple different ways to do this. I am going to show you one with a bolster today. So we are going to have a block down by our feet and our bolster here. If you only have yoga blocks, you may also just prop your hips up using a yoga block. That is also fine.
I want so that my shoulder blades are hitting the edge and my head is coming down towards the ground. If that is too much for you, you can always adjust to where it feels appropriate for you. You can also place something underneath your head if you feel like you need to support it a little bit more. But once you've found your position, go ahead and breathe. If this feels too intense for you, go ahead and shift to a supported bridge with the legs bent. That will be a little bit easier on your low back if you're feeling a lot in your low back. Any areas of tension in the hips, the low back, the rib cage. Breathe into those areas. Direct your breath there. And see if you can't help release some tension through breath. About two more long, deep breaths here. Remember to try and make your exhale longer than your inhale. Once you've completed your second breath, go ahead and bend those legs and we'll gently come off to the side if you were laying on top. All right, we're gonna come to a forward fold, seated, forward straddle. So you're going to spread your legs so they're in a straddle position. You can see if a couple yoga blocks is enough for you to relax your forehead. Maybe it is. Maybe you want even more support. So maybe you want your bolsters here. You can build yourself a little ramp to forward fold onto. That's usually my preference, but it really depends on what makes the most sense for you. You can make that ramp even higher, however you want. Make your ramp, and again, if you're gonna be turning your head to one side or the other, I will tell you when to switch sides. So build your ramp, however feels best for you, and relax. We do wanna make sure that your head is fully supported and your arms are relaxed. Your arms are not holding you up. Find somewhere where you feel a gentle stretch, but not something that is going to cause you to be uncomfortable. low back starting to ease. Pull on the hamstring is not as intense. You have your head to one side, go ahead and switch it now. Begin to deepen your breath. One more long, deep inhale. And an even longer exhale. When you're ready, go ahead and come up. Into our final pose for today. Going to ask you if you have yoga blocks to put them here at one end of your mat, and if you have a pillow or a bolster to lay that on top. So you're forming a little ramp. Your other one can be off to the side. And it does take a little adjusting, so don't worry if yours feels a little wobbly. You're gonna scooch your booty right to the back of your pillow or bolster. We're gonna lean back, and we're gonna have our feet in this butterfly position for a reclined butterfly. Now, if this feels too intense, you are always welcome to bring some cushions or pillows underneath your knees to support, or just extend your legs a little bit longer. All right, go ahead and find yourself in this nice reclined butterfly position as our final pose for today. Thank you. softness to the hips so that you're not gripping at the hip flexors. As we enjoy the last minute of today's practice. Welcome to stay here as long as you like, but if you're like me and you've got to move on with the rest of your day, begin to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Bring one hand to your thigh and gently bring your knee to center, then the other one. Open your eyes and gently roll up. Thank you so much for joining me for today's restorative yoga class. As always, it has been my honor and my pleasure to be here with you, and I'm so very proud of you for showing up to put in the work to help your body recover. Until